The National Farm Machine Show is back in Louisville, Kentucky, and we are here for yet another year. Today we're going to take a look at the South Hall, and then tomorrow we're going to take a look at the North Hall, then we're going to go over to the West Wing, and then day four we're going to conclude our trip by taking a look at the pavilion. But for now, let's take a look at this very patriotically painted Patriot. And with that, let's go ahead and move on into the Kentucky Expo Center. 1.3 million square feet under one single roof. First thing we see when we walk into the South Hall main entrance is a large John Deere 9RX. Signs that we have very big things to see here very soon. As we move over to the entryway of the South Hall, we have a New Holland T7. Nice, dark, deep blue. And with that, let's go ahead and move on into the South Hall. Now, one thing I did want to bring up is that throughout the first section of this video, I noticed that portions of my voiceovers were being cut off. I didn't realize that when I hit record, I needed to pause just a little bit longer than what I was seeing on the camera as far as the recording starting for the mic to totally initialize and pick up. So I do apologize for that, but I do make corrections for that throughout the video. And then for days 2, 3, and 4, well, we've got that figured out and we won't have that problem going forward. Here we have the new CR11 from New Holland. This thing is a beast. Connected to a MacDon header. Holland booth. We've already seen a little snippet of the CR11. We didn't get a chance to use it too far up close to it because it is roped off, but it does have a pretty cool ground sensing MacDon header. We have a big old T9 655. Thank you.
absolute beast of a machine. Tracks are probably about 5'9" as far as height. Drawbar hitch. And if you didn't think, round balers were huge. We have a New Holland round baler. Nice shot of the internals here. Festival net row. You can have yourself a New Holland Lego harvester. Yeah. Giel and Manitou booth. With some Giel skid steers and Manitou forklifts, telehandlers, here we have a Manitou telehandler engine up close. Everything that's serviceable seems to be in very easy to access locations. So we have the 630, 737, 841. This would be the biggest one here at the show. With a set of bail grabs there.
So I called Lou and he can.
Then we have a 533. Telescoping wheel loader with a massive, absolutely massive bucket on the back, or I should say on the front. TYM, interesting brand for kind of smaller tractors. Be interesting to see this, maybe could eventually come into the game. Here's one of their larger tractors that they have here at the show. Maybe more of a garden size tractor. Some of the TYM brush hog mower on the back. Here we have a nice smaller model. It'd be nice with a maybe an underdeck loader. This would be the T115 model. Dorf. We make awesome loaders. This company seems to specialize in loading equipment and other specialty attachments. We have an interesting demonstration here on some tilting bale loaders. Here we have a Landall B35 semi-trailer. And then the back end of this 7530 disc. And LS Tractor, lstractorusa.com. It's always going to be jobs around the farm for these little deals. Thinking about mucking out those classic tight UK cow barns. LS Tractor. The largest LS tractor here at the show, with the LL8100 loader attachment. This is the MT-5 or MT-S-73. Can you get in a camo skin? And not to be outdone, Case IH has also brought their variant of the New Holland CR11. The AF-11. Because sometimes we just need to be a little less original with our naming schemes. Or how about a harvester made out of wood? That's pretty cool. An AF-11 made out of wood. IH Precision Disc 550T. We see it here connected to a 380 with tracks. And these tracks are probably at least 6 foot plus. And it wouldn't be a proper case booth, but a Steiger quad track. Sorry, not a Steiger. The Steigers have wheels, not tracks. This would be the 715 model. I do believe we're seeing a redesigned nose on this one. Then we have a little Maxim 150. Still, rear wheels, probably close to 6 feet in diameter. Great Plains has got a pretty big booth here. Every booth with a giant Jumbotron is awesome. Couple smaller drills. Then we got some bigger machinery. Yes, yes, yes. You see the John Deere banner in the back. We will be getting to that soon enough. We all love big machines. So we have the PL5905. You can pause this here and just take a look at the 5905 Flyer front and back. It folds up under 16 foot to transport. And for what everyone's been waiting for, that's right, John Deere's next. But we don't only have machinery here. We also have the only officially sanctioned John Deere tractor pull, pedal car. Everybody's here for the John Deere loader equipment, right? Maybe a little Deere wheel loader, 204G. That's right. There's other stuff here that's actually green. I'll say a little loader. This thing has a huge bucket on it. Look at that bucket. John Deere 55 1M round baler. Complete with some full-size people as a frame of reference. It's connected here to a 5105M. Maybe a gator or two. Yeah. 6145M. Connected to a square baler.
This one?
There are the rear attachment that's going to flip it on its end, or its edge. When unloads. Crazy engineering of these knotters is just absolutely amazing.
Yep.
There we have the bailing computer, bailing display, massive flywheel, keep everything running once it's up to speed. And a little closer look at the 6145M. R sprayer. We have a 410 8RX, conveniently with a nice dude standing there in front of the tires or the tracks to give you again a sense of scale. Now the 8RX, which we just saw and we're about to see again, is actually equipped with some saddle tanks. Thank you. another, Paybuster is another brand that I'd really like to see come to the game. Bell shredders of all sorts of types. Picker. For those who are still playing with stones enabled. Really interesting design. We have rock bins with our offering here at the show. A mock-up of their drying system. And then on the off chance that anyone doesn't know what an actual bin looks like on the inside, we've got a cutaway bin. With the air floor. We even have quite an international presence here as well. Various log winches and blades. Really interesting stand-on loader. Kubota's got a big booth this year, maybe as big as John Deere or Case. Everyone's favorite side-by-sides. Here we have the M7. attached to a Kubota round baler. Opened up so we can see the nice mechanics inside. And then beside that, we've got an M6. It's connected to a butterfly mower. And here we have an M5. We have the AGI booth. We've got the 1539 Auger, Batco Auger built combination. Grain goes in there and then obviously shoots up. Here we have the new FX4 model, climbing up to 7,000 bushels per hour transfer rate. Now here at the GEA booth, we got our favorite angry tractor, the Dutes. Although I have to say, around where I'm at, typically the thing pulling the GEAs are gonna be the big fence. And we have it showing off its excellent terrain handling capabilities. Co, would that be how you pronounce this one? Specialized in mowers and other sorts of specialty attachments. This mower is quite interesting. It's got three decks that all independently float. And it can also fold up. Then here on the back, we've got several assorted small 3-point hitch spreaders. Some blades. Some brush mowers. And some vicious cutters here. And who doesn't love themselves a nice wheel rake? I'd like to see more of these come to the game, actually. If you're going to be using small bales, then you might as well use something like this, AE10 accumulator. You attach your baler right there. Be able to go up the chute, rotate itself around, and then find its way into this Plinko game, and eventually make its way into one of these four chutes. So then make it a whole lot easier to come around with a grabber. Grab those bales and load them up. Of course, they didn't have this 35 years ago. Would have been nice. Okay, everybody, let's play a game. What is this? Don't know? Let's find out. She's the Chrome Big X 1180 forage harvester. Opened up for all to see. A view we don't often get. Amazing engineering behind all of this. And yes, this tire is much, much taller than I. Oh, this control pad for manipulating the header here. Shows a fair bit of interest around Chrome with Straw Harvest recently releasing. We have an arm to help you load your net wrap into the baler. Easy Click 750-2.
Well, the buttons are running low on the shop buttons, so I need them to start working. I'm just going to do something. I don't know.
Maybe I'll have a square baler. Yeah, there's some apartments in New York City that are smaller than that bale chamber. You see here the twine coming in, going up, eventually to the Nodders. Can't reach up there. Storage. Of course, they have twine storage on both sides. There we have an additive tank on top of the flywheel. BKT tire. One of the tire brands that we have in game, of course. Showing off the various tire designs.
Makes it so great. It allows for the straight through shafts and belt drives that make the machine so reliable and efficient at transferring power.
And we've made it to AGCO. Ag Revolution. Gleaner. Fendt. Massey Ferguson.
It'll also allow for the distribution augers and the accelerator motor, which gives us the two stages of air cooling and increases the productivity of our cooling crew and provides for us that clean drain the natural flow process that makes all this stuff possible and only needs our life.
2850.
One of the things we did here at Gleaner was
53 horsepower.
Set all the different types of technologies that are out there so that they can best fit what works on their farm. If the customer has a true loyalty to the technology system and it's simple or something that they always use, we want to.
And here we have the Massey Ferguson 7S series. Is attached to a 1-series round baler. Again, opened up so we can see all the innards. Maybe the 7S isn't big enough for you. Over here at the 8S. Connected to the MEVF 1630 planter.
I would think so. I wouldn't know why there would be an issue. Now I would want to talk to you. This is a guy, is this going to feel comfortable in telling you about this?
We wouldn't want to hear about that.
Our 530 sprayer. Again, set up here showing off the terrain handling capabilities of this unit. Or maybe you'd be more interested in the greener variant with the Fendt 934H.
nice battery. Okay. But you have to have your brake. It helps it. It's light props.
But come on, please. What's it gonna take? To get cleaner. That's all we want. That's all we ask for. The S97. The classic galvanized look.
Leveling on these, where all the other brands do run leveling system.
Or the Gleaner header.
Gleaner's unique transverse rotor and accelerated rolls, and then some of these kits they put on for dividing the grain on the shoe, and we're able to cover these damn hills, drive them like a tractor, just as.
But at least we have the Fent 10T. Again, one of the best parts about these shows is you get to see the interior of this machinery. Something that's usually not exposed to us as players. Yep, all these tractors have horns, as we can hear.
The table where they're at. I've learned that myself.
Fit 728 Vario. Set up with duals, front and rear. Vince Momentum 23 Planter. Here we can see another example of the terrain capabilities of this particular planter. Now we have the smaller version of this in game. This is the ZATS 4200, but we have the 3000 series in game. And yes, these are full-size people standing behind this thing. If you ever wondered why your tractor tips forward after you connect one of these to fill the fertilizer, well, it's because it's a lot bigger than one might think. A lot bigger. Because it's actually connected to a 1050. and we all know 1050s are huge. So if the 1050 is huge, the ZATS 4200 spreader on the rear is also massive. Again, there are apartments smaller in New York City than the inside of that spreader.
Do we need that one?
This one might have enough power to pull it. Fit 942.
Where'd you guys get those cool hats from?
Tractor pull tractor. Here we have a Fendt 1162 Vario. All that weight pack between the tracks. Drive over auger belt. This is what we definitely need in game for all those belly dump trailers. And they really, really should think about disabling the horns. Because apparently that's the fun thing to do. This is the Norwood booth. Selling several Quick branded products. Very large disc. Quick till, quick cutter. Salford spreaders. Discs and such.
Yes, it keeps on going on.
only the most appropriate mowers for the Mayhem crew. Bad Boy branded mowers. They even have some electric varieties, but for some reason I don't think electric mowers work for a Bad Boy Stigma. They even have some smaller tractors. And we have a small grain cart here. The Brent, $13.98. Tracked variant, of course. We're on the inside of a dry spread spreader.
It was laying on my work bench for the Nico one.
Rolling harrow with seed box. Seed and fertilized tenders. And liquid fertilizer directly in ground with the disc. After 2030 DT strip tillage tool. Big old tanks on the back. Big old blower. Twin tires. The Extreme 1119 grain wagon. That tire is, yes, over 6 feet tall. Apache HS 1100 self-propelled sprayer. Mayer Manufacturing, made in USA forage products.
Kind of what I remember. He was like, oh, maybe this time we'll go and do it.
Just some small Degelman equipment. And to get you a different perspective on the huge silage blade that we started with. There's the back of it. I think we've seen this a few times in game. The Procast 80 precision granular applicator. And then we have the Hardy sprayers.
Yeah.
nicely illuminated from the inside. Connected to a fine Dukes 6000 series. Here we have the smaller Ranger series, Ranger 2000 spray tank. And then behind, the familiar Navigator 4000. Sure would be nice to see Cat in game as a possible brand. Now the Wolverine that we see here is a ditching machine, and it is designed to engineer ditches through a field, and as it was described to me, it's going to allow kind of track lines to be put in so heavy machinery can run through those engineered ditches, and then it's going to toss dirt out either side. There also is a rather sophisticated rock catching mechanism, because as you can expect, this can turn into a rather deadly rock thrower as well. Somebody want a brush mower? I think Woods has you covered.
It's all right.
Something else I wish we'd see a little bit more of are some more just normal, I guess, American style trailers, North American style trailers. Maybe Gator could come to the next farming simulator. Let me introduce you to the new Anderson Merge Pro 915 Merger. This thing is absolutely huge. The IFX 720 extractor, sausage wrapper as we so affectionately call it. Let's get a nice close look at these controls. How about a trailed Forager or the Dion Scorpion 300? How about Schaefer and their brand of loaders, their line of loaders, 3650T. T6680. Its long telescopic boom. Or the 5680T. The large 8620T, the largest one here at the show. Oh, that's a big bucket. Anybody ask for a sea tender from KBH, dual chamber, semi-trailer sea tender. Or maybe we need a supply trailer for our sprayers. It'd be great to see this come as an in-game standard item. I think we've seen another one of these earlier. Brandt Grain Dreck. Drive over unloader belt, perfect for belly dumps. And then the Brandt 1600 DXT. Or maybe a huge, heavy disc. H&S manure spreader, power spread 6138. Meridian fuel trailer. A seat hopper. You can have some nice tools in there and have a nice service trailer. And then if you prefer to handle your seed in boxes, for the Titan 2 XT. Set your seed boxes on top. And then offload into your seeder. The Capello Diamant corn header. Be cool in game if we could see these fold up like this. For servicing or for transport. We had a good look at the underneath. It's really something we haven't seen in game is the need for soil management, erosion management, and therefore the use of ditchers. Saw a ditcher earlier, the Wolverine. Here we have Hurricane, a whole company whose purpose is the manufacturing of ditchers.
And that is going to conclude our coverage of day one of the National Farm Machinery Show here in Louisville, Kentucky at the Kentucky Expo Center. A massive building, 1.3 million square feet under a single roof. And today we saw just a small portion, the South Hall specifically, of the machine show. We're going to see tomorrow the North Hall. And then the following day, we're going to take a look at the West Wing. And then the last day, we're going to cover the pavilion. Until next time, happy farming.